Good morning, children. Welcome to maths class. Today we are going to learn very interesting topic, and I hope you are aware about it. What it is? Perfect. It is something related to shapes. Now I will show you this picture. You will tell what it is. What kind of shape is this? Correct. It is a circle. Now regarding circle, we have learned in our previous classes also. We have learned some of the components of the circle. Now what is components of the circle? That is what things about circle. Okay. Now let me just recollect you with the components that we have seen. Now this circle, you can see a small dot over here. What is that dot called? Correct. It is called as the center of a circle. Now there are other components that we have seen. Can you guess something? Correct. If we draw a line, or we cut a circle from its end to the center, this half portion that we get, what is this half portion called? Correct. It is called as radius. That means what? See, radius is a line that is drawn from the center of the circle to the end. This half line is called as what? Your radius. Okay. Now you know that if we draw a complete line, see what I did, I have folded this part and I have just managed it to end by end. Now if I see in this part, you see that this is a straight line made. This fold or this line is a straight made. That means it is a line from the end to the end. Now such line which is drawn from end to end is called as what? Very good. It is called as a diameter. Now see, you can see over here that I have given a cut and I have two equal halves. Okay. This is a half where you see from exact end to the circle and you see a line. Now the line which passes from this center and it joins the circle is called as what? Diameter. Okay. So very important concepts. This is your circle. This is the center of the circle. Okay. From center, when there is a line drawn, it is the half of the portion of the circle. If this is the case, this is only the half of the circle that is focused. This half part of the circle or the line from the center of the circle to the end of the circle is called as the radius. And the line which joins the two points on the circle, okay, which passes from the center is called as what? Diameter. That means, see, if this is your circle, if this is your entire circle, you can cut it in this way. You can cut it. You can cut it in this way. You can cut it in this way. The only thing is your line passes through the center. I can, if this is my whole circle, okay, I can show this as the diameter in this way, where you will see that the line is passing from the center, though it became a slanting line. Okay, it appeared to be a slanting line, but it passed from the center. So this concept is called as diameter. Okay, see, diameter, line passes from the center only. It can be a standing line, it can be a sleeping line, it can be a slanting line in any of the way, but the thing is it should pass from the center. That becomes the diameter. And the next concept that we have learnt is what? A chord. That means if this is your circle, okay? You know that circle is made up of many small, small dots, okay? Now, when any two dots, okay, these are the small, small dots on the circle. When any two dots are joined with a line, that line is called as what? Chord. Okay, if I want to join this dot, let me name this dot as A and this dot as C. These two points, that is point A and point C, are joined by a line. This line is called as what? Chord. That means chord is a line segment which joins any two points on the circle. Now you will have a question. If we talk about the diameter, diameter also are the points that are joined on the line. That is, they are the points on the circle and they are joined by a line. And that line is passing through the center. So, it can be a chord. Isn't it? Perfect. So, diameter is the longest chord. Diameter is also a chord. And it is specified that it is a longest chord. Because chord tells us ki it is a line that joins any two points on the circle. And diameter is the case where points are joined, but that line passes through the center. That means it is one of the biggest line that is drawn in the circle. That means it is the longest chord. I hope you have understood the concept over here. What is the radius? What is the diameter? And what is the chord? Now see, this concept of radius, diameter, chord, you don't have for your exam. As government has reduced some of the syllabus, this syllabus is not there from the exam point of view. But it is very important because next year you are going to learn all these things again. In that case, if you are not aware about the radius, chord and diameter, then you will have to learn from zero. Which I don't want. At least you should be aware about the terms. Okay. So this is your self-study which you will be practicing at home. We will just have a look over the concept over here. In the exam, this concept of circle will not come. But you will practice by yourself as this learning is going to be carried forward for our next year. Next year, we hope that there won't be any lockdown. We are going to meet in the school. In that case, if you are not aware of all these things, it is very difficult to learn about this concept. So please pay attention and just discuss about this. Okay. So on the page number 41, you have here a circle drawn with a center O and there are various lines. So we have to identify which is the chord among this circle, which is a diameter and which is a radius. Now always you have learnt about it in the previous class as well, that when we talk about the components, we start it with a name segment. Why segment? See, because segment is what? It is a line which has point at the end. This is one point, this is the other point, okay? Between these two points, you draw a line. So, this line is called as a segment in maths, okay? And if we talk about a circle, circle is made up of various points and we are joining a point A and point B. That means, ideally, we are joining two points, means here is one end, here is one end. That means it should be called as a segment. So we will name it as a segment AP. Okay. That is the way you define the segment of either radius, diameter or a chord. Okay. So focusing over here, the first question we have about the radius. Now radius, what is the concept that we have seen? That it is a line from the center of the circle to the periphery or at the end. So, tell me what all are the segments over here which can be said as radius. Fantastic. Segment OS. Segment OM. segment OP and segment OT. Very good. These are the four lines which start from the center and end at the periphery. That is why it is called as radius. Now talking about the diameter, we have to focus on the center of the circle. So line which will pass from the center of the circle, that will be the diameter. Okay. Now whether it is standing line, sleeping line, slanting line, we should not focus for that. We should just see, the is the line passing from the center of the circle and it is joining the two points, then it is a diameter. Okay. Now you will see from the center there are two lines passing. One line you see here, point P and point S. It's joining these two points. So we will name over here that segment PS is the diameter. And other you say segment MT as the diameter. Very good. Now here in case of chord, what will you say? Perfect. You will say segment M and T, segment P and S, and segment N and M. Correct? And when you talk about segment P and S, you will specify in the bracket as longest chord. Segment M and T in the bracket, longest chord. Okay? And N and M, it is just a chord because N is the point and M is the point and they are joined by a line. So that is why you will just say segment NM is a chord. Fine. I hope you have understood this concept. You will be reading the sentences over here clearly and you will be solving this in the textbook itself. Okay. Let's move towards the next concept. Now we will come to a very, very interesting topic over here, drawing a circle. Now you see in your geometry box, that is in your instrument box, you have this kind of instrument. It is called as a compass or rounder. Okay. Now we are going to use this compass or rounder to draw a circle. Okay. Now there are few things which are to be compulsorily followed so that your circle comes exact shape. Okay. The very first thing is the pencil that you use. It should be smaller than this height. Okay. That means whenever you see the pencil, okay, the pencil should not be bigger than this. So you have to take a pencil height, choose the pencil height accordingly and then fix this pencil in this compass. The very first thing, is it understood? If you take a bigger pencil, your pencil should not be big than this. Okay. That means it should be somewhere here or here. Okay. Of that height. Okay. This is the first thing to be followed. Then second important thing here, what is that? Whenever you fix a pencil, you have to keep some distance between the compass. Okay. It should not be closed like this. This is called as closed position. You have to open it a bit. Okay. And then you have to open the screw and then put your pencil. Now see, while inserting and fixing the pencil, you have to take care that you keep it over something. Okay. See the position that I am doing. Okay. First thing what I did, I kept some distance, okay, between the pencil and this. That means I opened a bit, okay. Then I fixed my pencil. Now what I will do, before fixing, I will keep it on the paper, okay. And I will see, I will hold here at the tip, okay. Always the compass should be holded at here at the tip. Do not hold like this. This is not the correct position. Always hold a compass at the end over here. This is its holding point. This is its holding point. Okay. Now I will hold in this way and see whether my pencil is coming proper on the paper over here at the same height of this pointer. this pointer height and my pencil height both should be of the same level. If your pencil is going to come down in this way, see, is it coming same? No, it's the slanting position, that is incorrect. So you have to take care that both height, the pencil as well as your compass, they fall on a same line. Okay, the pencil to be holded in this way for fixing so that it fixes properly. See, yeah, compass to be holded with left hand in this way, pencil to be holded in this way tightly like this. See, tightly in this way and then fix the screw. Okay, now you will see after I fix, my both are of same level. Okay, this is how it has to be there. Now second thing what you require is the scale. Now always while drawing a circle, there is radius given. Okay, why radius is given? See, radius is what? It is a line from the center to the end. Radius is point from center to the end. Okay, now when you draw, this point is the center of the circle and you are drawing it in this way. Okay, so always a radius is given. Now how do you measure a radius? You need a scale for this. See, for constructing a circle you require a compass and a scale. Now for example, I say that I want you to draw a circle of 3 cm. What you do? You open your compass. इसको ऐसे बढ़ाना है, okay? And then this pointer end should fall on zero. Scale का जो zero marking है, you will keep it over there. Point should not now be changed, okay? And then wherever your 3 cm is coming, your pencil point should fall. Now this became your 3 cm. Okay, I hope you have got it. I repeat it again. While measuring, you have to take care that your compass end should fall on zero of the scale and your pencil end falls on the number of the radius that is asked. Now I have asked you to draw a circle of 3 cm. So I measured and this became your 3 cm. Now I will hold the compass in this way, that is at the top over here, and I will fix wherever I want a circle. Supposingly I want my circle over here. Now after I have placed the compass, I will not move the compass at all. Compass ek bar fix kiya ki usko hilana nahi hai. If you move, your radius will change and you will not get a proper circle. To isko aise tightly hold karna hai. You have to hold your compass here tightly, okay? And then you have to just move your hand from left to right, okay? Left to right and right to left, okay? This is how your circle is ready now. You will see here the circle is ready, okay? Now see, in this now, after you have drawn the circle, you will see that it's ready. So the point where you have placed your compass, this becomes what? The center of the circle. I say it has to be supposingly point O. You have to name it, okay? And then if you draw if you want to draw a radius, you can draw a line from the center to the end. Now this point you can name anything. So I can say supposingly it as ON. Okay, this you can label as you wish. If you draw a line from passing through the center, okay, in this way, this became your diameter. Very good. I name it as A and Z, okay? And supposingly I draw another line, okay, and I join A and N, okay? Now A and became what? Very good, chord. So I can say over here that radius, how much is my radius? Okay, 3 cm that I have taken. Okay, and what is the segment over here? O and N. So I say radius, segment, you can say in short SEG, no problem. Segment O and N, then segment O and Z, segment O and Z, and segment O and A. That is how you say about the radius. Then if you want to talk about the chord, what you will you say? Okay, you will say chord. Which is the chord? Segment AN. Very good. And you will say segment AZ, longest chord. I want you to specify this because it is the diameter. And if I ask a diameter, what will you say? Diameter, you will say segment AZ. Okay, so AZ is diameter as well as the chord, but it is the longest chord. Okay, fine. So I hope you have understood how to draw a circle. I will again discuss one circle construction with you, and then the exercise part you have to do by yourself. As now, again important, construction is also not going to be asked in the exam as it is the reduced syllabus. But you should be aware about it, so I am showing you everything. Okay. Now, supposingly I say I want you to draw a circle of 6 cm. So what will you do? This is your compass end. Compass end falls on 0 of your scale, and pencil falls on the perfect. It falls on the 6 because I want 6 cm. Okay. So you have to take care and adjust your compass in such a way that point of the compass is on 0 of the scale and pencil is exactly on the 6. Now my this distance became how much? 6 cm. Now I want to draw. So what I do? I fix anywhere wherever I want to draw. I feel that I should draw over here. Okay? I fix it over here. Ekdam pakka fix, okay? And then I will have to just move my hand without lifting. Aap ye compass ko uthaoge to circle bigadne wala hai. So you will have to take care about it. Ki without lifting, you have to just move your hand from left to right and left to left. Pehle kaam karna, agar ye aapki gadbad ho rahi hai na, तो पहले सिर्फ ये कंपास की मूवमेंट सीख लो. फिक्स इट ऑन अ पॉइंट समवेयर एंड जस्ट ट्राई टू रोटेट इट. आई डोंट वांट यू टू होल्ड ऐसे और ऐसे. ये करोगे ना तो ये बिगड़ने वाला है. तो व्हाट यू विल डू, आई वांट यू टू प्रैक्टिस बाय होल्डिंग एट द टिप ओनली. इधर ही पकड़ो और कहीं नहीं पकड़ो. इधर पकड़ो और इसको गोल 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 घुमाओ. ये प्रैक्टिस पहले करो एंड देन लेटर यू फिक्स इट एंड देन ट्राई टू डू इट. I am sure you will do various types of circles and do it very perfectly. Okay, so here first part of the circle is over. Today here I conclude, and next maths class we will come towards the next topic. Now today no PDF for you. You will practice problem set 28 by yourself. Okay, you will watch the video if you have a doubt, and you will do by yourself. Okay, so page number 41, whatever part I discussed with you, you will solve it over here only. Page number 41, discussed part has to be written over here, and problem set 28 has to be solved as homework. No PDF for reference, video is reference for you. Okay, so bye, see you in the next maths class with more interesting topic. Bye. Good morning children, welcome to maths class. Today we are going to learn very interesting topic, and I hope you are aware about it. What it is? Perfect. It is something related to shapes. Now I will show you this picture. You will tell what it is. What kind of shape is this? Correct. It is a circle. Now, regarding circle, we have learned in our previous classes also. We have learned some of the components of the circle. Now, what is components of the circle? That is what? Things about circle. Okay. Now, let me just recollect you with the components that we have seen. Now, this circle, you can see a small dot over here. What is that dot called? Correct. It is called as the center of a circle. Now, there are other components that we have seen. Can you guess something? Correct. If we draw a line or we cut a circle from its end to the center, this half portion that we get, what is this half portion called? Correct. It is called as radius. That means what? See, radius is a line that is drawn from the center of the circle to the end. This half line is called as what? Your radius. Okay. Now, you know that if we draw a complete line, see what I did? I have folded this part and I have just managed it to end by end. Now, if I see in this part, you see that this is a straight line made. This fold or this line is a straight made. That means it is a line from the end to the end. Now, such line which is drawn from end to end is called as what? Very good. It is called as a diameter. Now, see, you can see over here that I have given a cut and I have two equal halves. Okay. This is a half where you see from exact end to the circle and you see a line. Now, the line which passes from this center and it joins the circle is called as what? Diameter. Okay. So, very important concepts. This is your circle. This is the center of the circle. Okay. From center, when there is a line drawn, it is the half of the portion of the circle. If this is the case, this is only the half of the circle that is focused. This half part of the circle or the line from the center of the circle to the end of the circle is called as the radius. And the line which joins the two points on the circle, okay, which passes from the center is called as what? Diameter. That means, see, if this is your circle, if this is your entire circle, you can cut it in this way. You can cut it in this way. The only thing is your line passes through the center. I can, if this is my whole circle, okay, I can show this as the diameter in this way, where you will see that the line is passing from the center, though it became a slanting line. Okay, it appeared to be a slanting line, but it passed from the center. So, this concept is called as diameter. Okay, see, diameter, line passes from the center only. It can be a standing line, it can be a sleeping line, it can be a slanting line in any of the way. But the thing is, it should pass from the center. That becomes the diameter. And the next concept that we have learned is what? A chord. That means if this is your circle, okay, you know that circle is made up of many small dots. Okay. Now, when any two dots, okay, these are the small dots on the circle. When any two dots are joined with a line, that line is called as what? Chord. Okay, if I want to join this dot, let me name this dot as A and this dot at C. These two points, that is point A and point C, are joined by a line. This line is called as what? Chord. That means chord is a line segment which joins any two points on the circle. Now you will have a question. If we talk about the diameter, diameter also are the points that are joined on the line. That is, they are the points on the circle and they are joined by a line, and that line is passing through the center. So it can be a chord, isn't it? Perfect. So diameter is the longest chord. Diameter is also a chord, and it is specified that it is a longest chord because chord tells us ki it is a line that joins any two points on the circle. And diameter is the case where points are joined, but that line passes through the center. That means it is one of the biggest line that is drawn in the circle. That means it is the longest chord. I hope you have understood the concept over here. What is the radius? What is the diameter? And what is the chord? Good morning, children. Welcome to our maths class. And let us learn very interesting topic in circles. I hope you have understood how to draw a circle, or we say it has to be the construction of a circle. See, here we have a circle. Now we have seen that compass is the instrument which is used to draw a circle, and while drawing we measure the compass. This measurement is called as the radius. Now how it is radius, that we will see today. See, now whenever we want to draw, what do? We fix it on the paper. The compass end is fixed on the paper, and then the pencil end is dragged and it is moved in a circular manner. This is how you construct a circle. We fix it on a paper and then we draw. Now the point where we fix, this becomes the center of the circle. Let us name it with any of the point as point X. Here the circle drawn point O. Like this we can draw the circle. Now we will see over here ki how this is radius. See, when I kept it over the point over here and I dragged it, this covered only half of the part. Okay. Now when I take it over the other side, it also covers only the half of the part. Okay. So when from the center to the periphery when you come, you say that line or that distance to be as your radius. Okay, this becomes as what? Your radius. Now in this case we will see whatever is the measurement of the radius, when it is doubled, this as one time this radius. Now if here the radius is 4 cm, is it going to change by coming over here? No. This 4 cm radius is constant from this point till the any point on the circle. For example, now here if we measure the radius, it is coming as 4 cm. Okay. If I check it from this side, did it change? No. It remained 4 cm as it is. Did it change over here? No. It remained 4 cm as it is. That means this radius is going to remain constant. Okay. That is why that is the center. From center if you check, it is going to remain constant only. Okay. If I now draw this whole line. Okay. It covers the complete path of the circle. Okay. That we say has to be the diameter. Now this 4 centimeter radius and the other 4 centimeter radius, this side 4 and this side 4, when the line completes, it gives you total how much centimeter? 4 plus 4 is equals to what? 8. This whole line is also said as what? Very good. Diameter. That means we will understand here the measure of diameter is double that of radius, or we say two times that of radius. Okay, whatever is your radius, when you double it, that means what? Add it two times, you will get the measurement of your diameter. Okay, let's take here the next circle drawn. Let's see what is the measure. It is coming to be as what? 5.5 centimeter. Now tell me, will your radius change anywhere? No. You take from this side also, it will give you the same. Now if I draw this whole line, what it did it become? Very good. It became your diameter. Okay. This is your radius. Okay. Now from radius, let us say as O and A. O and A became your radius, and what is the measurement? 5.5. Now if I want to calculate D and A, D and A is what? Point D and point A are joined by a line, and that line is passing from center O. That means that is what your, yes, segment DA is your diameter. Now if this is 5.5, this O and D will be also 5.5, right? That means if we add 5.5 plus 5.5, what it will it give you? Good. It will give you 11 centimeter. That means your diameter is double of your radius. So either you can add 5.5 two times, or in the other way you can say 5.5 multiplied by 2. Adding two times and multiplication two times is one and the same. So that is how you see here the connection between the radius and the diameter. I hope this is understood. Let's move ahead. On page number 43, you have there two tests. Okay. If we see the test one over here. Okay. See, all the diameters of the circle are of the same length. Even the radius are of same length and diameter are also of same length. Now see, here three circles are given. Okay. You have to take your scale and measure how much is the radius and then talk about the diameter. Okay. Now if we talk about the first is given to you radius first 1 centimeter. That means the diameter will be what? 1 plus 1, 2. Now in the second picture, let us see. I keep my zero end, that is the first line of my scale, on the zero, and then measure. Now after measuring, I come to know here that from radius to this, this is 2 centimeter. That means my radius is what? My radius here is 2 centimeter. Then how much will be my diameter? 2 plus 2. This 2 plus this 2 will give me what? 4. Very good. So the diameter become as 4 centimeter double. So you have to say either 2 2s are 4 or 2 plus 2 4. Okay. So that's how here if the radius is 2 centimeter, the diameter is 4 centimeter. Very good. Now in this the third case, let us see from point till the end, how much is this distance? Very good. It is 3 centimeter. Okay. See, while measuring, you have to take care that your first line of the scale, which is called as the zero line, that should fall on the point, that is the center point, and till the periphery, the number that you get is the length. Now this 3 plus 3 is what? Very good. 6. Okay. So radius is 3 centimeter. So diameter is 6 centimeter. Or you can say 3 2s are 6. 6 centimeter. I hope this concept is clear. Now on the same page 43, see the problem set 29. I am not going to send the PDF, so please listen carefully and write accordingly in your notebook. If the radius of a circle is 5 cm, what will be its diameter? Now this answer has to be written in words. Now first tell me what will be the diameter. Fantastic. It is how much? 10, because 5 plus 5, 5 is the radius. So double of 5 is what? 5 plus 5, or in the other words, 5 into 2. So the answer comes at what? 10. That means you will say that if the radius is 5 cm, the diameter is 10 cm. You have to write in words. Okay. Second one. If the diameter of a circle is 6 cm, what will be its radius? Tell me, 6 plus 6, 12, or 6 twos are 12. Very good. So in words you are going to write it. If the diameter of a circle is 6 cm, see now this second one, okay, radius is not given. What is given? Diameter is given. Okay, if the diameter is 6, how much will be the radius? Half of 6. So half of 6 is how much? 3. That means it is what? 3 cm. Okay. If your radius is 6, then the diameter is 12. Correct. But here diameter is 6 given. So that means what? You will divide it by 2. If you don't know half, what you do, the number has to be divided by 2. So 2 threes are, you get 6. That means the radius is 3 cm. Okay. Now this radius and diameter concept is also not going to come for the exam. Okay. You just have to remember these concepts, because you are going to take this ahead for your next year. Okay. Now come to page number 44. See, question number 3 is given. Complete the following table by filling in the blanks. Radius 4 cm. So diameter is what? Double of 4, 4 plus 4, 8 cm. Then radius is not given. Diameter is given. Now if 16 is the diameter, how much is the radius? How do you find? You divide 16 by 2. In the table of 2, you get 2 8s are 16. That means the radius is 8. Same way, if radius is 9, 9 plus 9 is what? 18. That means the diameter is 18. Diameter is 22. How much is the radius? 22 divided by 2. That gives you 11. That means the radius is 11. So that's the concept of what is the radius and what is the diameter. I hope this concept is very much understood. Let's move towards the next concept now. On page number 43, you have there two tests. Okay. If we see the test one over here, okay, see, all the diameters of the circle are of the same length. Even the radius are of same length and diameter are also of same length. Now see, here three circles are given. Okay. You have to take your scale and measure how much is the radius and then talk about the diameter. Okay. Now if we talk about the first is given to you radius first 1 cm, that means the diameter will be what? 1 plus 1, 2. Now in the second picture, let us see, I keep my zero end, that is the first line of my scale, on the zero and then measure. Now after measuring, I come to know here that from radius to this, this is 2 cm. That means my radius is what? My radius here is 2 cm. Then how much will be my diameter? 2 plus 2. This 2 plus this 2 will give me what? 4. Very good. So the diameter become as 4 cm double. So you have to say either 2 2s are 4 or 2 plus 2 4. Okay. So that's how here, if the radius is 2 cm, the diameter is 4 cm. Very good. Now in this, the third case, let us see, from point till the end, how much is this distance? Very good, it is 3 cm. Okay, see, while measuring, you have to take care that your first line of the scale, which is called as the zero line, that should fall on the point, that is the center point, and till the periphery, the number that you get is the length. Now this 3 plus 3 is what? Very good, 6. Okay, so radius is 3 centimeter, so diameter is 6 centimeter, or you can say 3 twos are 6 centimeter. I hope this concept is clear. Now on the same page 43, see the problem set 29. I am not going to send the PDF, so please listen carefully and write accordingly in your notebook. If the radius of a circle is 5 centimeter, what will be its diameter? Now this answer has to be written in words. Now first tell me what will be the diameter. Fantastic. It is how much? 10, because 5 plus 5, 5 is the radius. So double of 5 is what? 5 plus 5, or in the other words, 5 into 2. So the answer comes at what? 10. That means you will say that if the radius is 5 centimeter, the diameter is 10 centimeter. You have to write in words. Okay. Second one. If the diameter of a circle is 6 centimeter, what will be its radius? Tell me, 6 plus 6, 12, or 6 twos are 12. Very good. So in words you are going to write it. If the diameter of a circle is 6 centimeter, see now this second one, okay, radius is not given. What is given? Diameter is given. Okay, if the diameter is 6, how much will be the radius? Half of 6. So half of 6 is how much? 3. That means it is what? 3 centimeter. Okay, if your radius is 6, then the diameter is 12. Correct. But here diameter is 6 given. So that means what? You will divide it by 2. If you don't know half, what you do, the number has to be divided by 2. So 2 threes are, you get 6. That means the radius is 3 centimeter. Okay. Now this radius and diameter concept is also not going to come for the exam. Okay. You just have to remember these concepts, because you are going to take this ahead for your next year. Okay. Now come to page number 44. See, question number 3 is given. Complete the following table by filling in the blanks. Radius 4 cm. So diameter is what? Double of 4, 4 plus 4, 8 cm. Then radius is not given. Diameter is given. Now if 16 is the diameter, how much is the radius? How do you find? You divide 16 by 2. In the table of 2, you get 2 8s are 16. That means the radius is 8. Same way, if radius is 9, 9 plus 9 is what? 18. That means the diameter is 18. Diameter is 22. How much is the radius? 22 divided by 2. That gives you 11. That means the radius is 11. So that's the concept of what is the radius and what is the diameter. I hope this concept is very much understood. Let's move towards the next concept now. Now see, on page number 44, you have the next concept given over, the interior and the exterior of a circle. Now see, the word interior itself tells us it is in. Now whatever is inside the circle is called interior, and whatever is outside of the circle is called exterior. It is not a part, that means it is X. So it is exterior. So exterior means what? Outside the circle, and interior means inside the circle. Okay. Now here we are going to talk about the points that are inside the circle and that are outside the circle. Now see, in this diagram, you have so many points in as well as so many points out, and some points on the circle. So you specify them. Like see, now point P, point R, point T and point Q. These are the points inside the circle. That means they are interior points. You say the points as the interior points. Okay. Now, there are some points which are outside, like your point C, point A, point B, point D. This you see the point written outside. That means they become as what? Exterior points. And you see that this point N or your point K or your point L and your point M, they are shown on the circle. That means you will specify over here point A, point N, point K, point L and point M. These are the points on the circle. So on the circle, inside the circle and outside the circle. And mathematical terms as for inside it is interior points, for outside as exterior points, and on the circle it is said as on the circle only, no specific term. Okay, but you have to write the word point point. Okay, see in the problem set 30 diagram is given. Okay, now let us talk about, you are going to do in the same way in your notebook. What is shown? Points in the interior of the circle. Now in interior means inside. Now what part is inside? The dark blue. Now what all points you say? Point Y, point R, point T and point X. So you will write in that way point, point, then put a dash, then write Y, comma R, comma T, comma X. Okay, then points in the exterior of the circle, that means which are outside. So which points you see outside? Point W, point M and point Z. Okay, and points on the circle, you see point N is exactly on the circle, point P is exactly on the circle. Okay, so these two points you say as points on the circle. Okay, so that's the concept of the interior and the exterior and the point on the circle. I hope you have understood whatever we have learned till now. Please revise, draw the circles, okay, measure the radius and diameter and the inside and the exterior part of the circle. Till here we don't have anything for our exam. You just have to revise the terms and get it understand as you are going to take it for your next classes for your maths. Okay, chalo, bye, thank you. By the time, please practice well. Good morning children, welcome to our maths class. See children, today we will be learning very interesting topic, which is the circumference. Now what is circumference? Circumference is nothing but boundary. What is circumference? Circumference is nothing but it is the boundary of a circle. Now see, if you have this square shape, okay, what you can do if you want to measure the length and breadth? What you do? You take a scale. You see how much is the length. For example, this is 5 cm. You see how much is breadth. For example, it is 4 cm. You say that here we have a rectangle who has the length of 5 cm and breadth as 4 cm. But if you have a circle, can you rotate your scale and find how much is the length of this? No. But you have a radius by which you will understand what is the distance from the center and how much far is the circle drawn from the center. So to find the length of your circle, we have the concept called as the circumference. Circumference means only the boundary part. Okay, now rest all other shapes, okay, has length and breadth which can be measured by a scale. And that is why when we talk about the boundary of all other shapes, you say that we talk about the perimeter of that shape. Now in the next term, we will talk about these terms, that is the perimeter. Perimeter means it is boundary. Okay, and the shape like your square, your pentagon, your hexagon, your rectangle, all these can be measured with a scale. Boundaries can be measured properly with a scale, and that is why you say that we find the perimeter of those shapes.
but you can't use your scale for doing this directly, and that is why we say the word as circumference for this circular length measurement. Okay, now how it can be measured? Now see, we can make use of a string over here. I take this circular object, it is your what, sellotape. Okay, I start my measurement from here. Okay, now what I do, I started over here, I rotate this thread, it is your friendship band. I hold it in this way over here, I hold it in this way tightly, and I just rotate it and I bring back over here. Now I started over here, so I end over here. Now you will see that it is circulated by all the path. I end over here, so I hold it in this way. Now I leave the tape. Now this much, whatever length I get, is called as what? Your boundary of a circle or the circumference of a circle. Now I hold a scale. I keep my end of this on the zero, and I just keep the thumb over here wherever I have ended my friendship band, and it gives to be as your 13 centimeter. That means you say that the circumference of this tape is what, 13 centimeter. Okay, like this I can take any of the circular object. I take this bangle, okay, I keep it over here, I start rotating it. Okay, after completing the one round, I will leave it and see how much it is giving me. The other simple way is hold it down, okay, and then rotate it. Now this gave you your circumference of your bangle. You will hold it tightly, it will show you proper measurement. You hold it like this. See, this is what your bangle is showing, your circumference. Now I open it and I hold it and I check it. How much is my circumference giving? It is showing you as your 19 centimeter. That means the circumference of this circle is 19 centimeter. Like this, you can use any of the circular objects. See, I have here a big tape. Okay, I start measuring. I cover it with all the boundaries. Here it ends. I take it out. Use a scale. Okay, hold it to the zero. Hold it to the zero. Now I come over here, I get this as 29 centimeter. Now in this way you can take string, okay, string is what, your dhaga, okay, and you can check the circumference of various circular objects you see at home. So today's work is finding the various circular objects in home and finding the circumference of those objects. I hope you have understood the concept of circumference well. Okay, let's move towards the next concept over here, which is related to the circumference. Okay, let's see over here now concept called as arc of the circle. Now see, here you see a ring and it has various points. That is, it is a circle, and on the circle there are points as S, M, D and L. Okay, now you see that they are on the circle. So if I cut this into two halves, let us assume that now I am cutting this into two halves. Okay,
So what points are left? Point S, point M and point D. That means this side became one part and this side became the other part. This formation of the part is called as the arc of the circle. Okay, and arc always have one starting point and one end point. Though it may have other points as well. Now in this case, point S, point D, point M, these three are the points of this part. Okay, but when we name the arc, we will start with the starting point and we'll end with the end point. So after cutting this, we got this much part, okay, which is the starting part, point S, and ending point D. So you will say this has a this arc of the circle. Which part you got? Arc SD or DS, in any of the way you can say. Okay, if there are three parts and no point, now in this case there is an arc having three points. Okay, so you can also say over here as arc SMD. This shows that starting is S and ending is D, and there is some between point as N. Okay, if now I have only this much part, for example, let me cut and show you. There are so many points. Now what will I do? I just cut this, okay, start from S and end at M. This became one part of the circle. Okay, then I cut over here. That means this became the other part of the circle. I cut over here. This became the third part and this became the fourth part. That means this circle is divided in how many parts? Four parts. Okay, now when I join, a circle is formed. Okay, but if I want to talk about the specific part of the circle, I say that it has to be the arc of the circle. Now here these two are the points which are dividing the circle into one part. Okay, so we will say arc S and L. This is the other part which is getting divided, which we will say arc D and S. It is D and, okay, it's the other way over here, like this. So in this way you can label the parts and say as to be the arc of the circle. In so many parts it is getting divided. So that's how we talk about the arc of the circle. If I make two parts, this becomes the half. So we say that this is arc L and D or LSD. If I cut this, this becomes arc DS, arc SL, and in this way you can say in any of the part as the arc of the circle. The concept is arc means it is a part. Okay, there can be only two parts or three parts or four parts depending upon how many points are there on the circle. In that way we can talk about the any of the parts and say that that has to be the arc of the circle. I hope it's understood. Let's move towards the exercise 31, which is the last part of this lesson. Let's see the practice set 31, that is problem set 31. See, in the figure given alongside, points S, L, M and N are on the circle. Answer the question with the help of the diagram. Write the names of the arcs with end points S and M. Okay, that means we have to name the arc. Starting should be what? S and M. So we can say here as arc S, L, M, or we can say here as arc S, N and M. That means, see, here either we can go in this words and start from S and end with M,
or we can go these words and start with S and end with M. So we will say over here, in words you have to write saying ARC arc, SLM and arc SNM are the arcs of the circle with end points S and M. Okay, now tell me what will be the other one. You want the arcs with end points L and N. So how will you say? Very good. Arc L M N and arc L S N are the arcs of the circle with L end points N and N. Very good. Let's see the next here. Write the names of the arcs that points A, B, C and D in the given circle gives rise to. Now tell me what will it happen. Okay, arc ABC will be one arc. Okay, and arc ADC will be the other arc. Or you can say as arc DAB and arc DAC. See, the concept here is telling you what? Ki you take every point as the end point. First time take A as the end point. Okay, next time take B as the end point. Next time take C and next time take D. That means consider any of the part and name as many arcs you can. So you can say arc ABC, arc ADC. If you take point D, you will get arc DCB and arc DAB. If you take C as the end point, you get arc CDA and arc CBA. Okay. You can even come to C, A and directly D also. Okay. So depending upon how much you want the part, you can talk about it. See the third one. Give the names of the arcs that are made by points P, Q, R, S and T in the figure. It is the same again now. Okay. Starting from P, you can say PQR or you can say as PRS. Coming to this side, you can say PTS. Okay. So, in any of the way, you can start and you can see. If you start with Q, you will say arc QRS. If you come to this side of Q, you will say QTS. Okay. Or QPT. Any way, wherever you want to break the circle, you can break the circle and you can name the arc. Okay. But in that case, you have to decide ki what if you start with P, what you want end point? You want R as the end point or you want S as the end point or T as the end point. It is your wish. Okay. So that's about the three of the questions. Then come to the last one. Measure and note down the circumference of different circular objects. It is convenient to use a measuring tape for this. Now see, that's what I gave you homework, finding the circumference of the circle. So children, here we have completed with this chapter, that is the circle. Now here I have concluded the syllabus for your first semester exam. You have three lessons, study well, practice well, and you can solve any number that is given. Okay. In the exam, 90% you will get numbers which you have not tried in the textbook. Okay. And I want you to gain mastery over the subject. That is why I have gave you the numbers that you have not practiced in the practice set. So make the practice set thorough so that any number is given for multiplication, division, you don't have any problem to do. So all the best for your exam. Practice well. For any of the doubt, watch the video and you can do very, very, very well. Okay. Bye and thanks everyone for watching the videos and loving the subject.